coverage of the Grand National for more than half a century, and during that time we've done some rather unique things to demonstrate just how special this race really is.
In the early 70s, international show jumper Harvey Smith and former Grand National second Pat McCarron decided to go round before the days of health and safety and insurance.
This is one of the biggest runs in Europe.
It is.
If you go out over here, you know you're jumping.
Hey, we're off.
And how prophetic was that? Pat McCarron gets dislodged, but Harvey takes a grip and pulls up. They agree to swap horses. Would this make any difference?
Right, the next one's like stepping off the edge of the world.
Hey?
This is the big one.
Yeah.
What do you think of that?
I can tell you what he thought of that. He broke his collarbone, but he was here to jump the fences, and that's exactly what he did.
I think horsing a rider that wins that course deserves every penny they get.
They do, don't they?
I don't care what fees you fellas get, you deserve double.
And it wasn't very much in those days. John Oaksey on the right and myself tried to emulate them.
But there we are, coming to the second at a good pace. This fella really taking hold as he sees it. Whoa, not too bad.
This is the one, isn't it?
This is Peaches, John, yep.
You've got to mind the step. Whoa, I called a bit of a cab.
Nearly bit the dust there.
Now, don't you bloody well start coming in on me either.
Well, let's cut out and cut right in over the corner, as it should be done. We'll show these younger jockeys how it should be done.
Not bad.
No, not bad, John.
A year later, Princess Anne came up to see her husband, Mark Phillips, ride the Queen's grey horse, Columbus. I was on Barony Fort, who'd refused the year before.
Well, this shouldn't prove any problem.
So we don't stand off the sex spot as far as that.
Yes, it looks big.
It obviously looked bigger to Barony Fort than it did to me, but I wasn't to be deterred, and Mark Phillips was insistent that we go on. Going down to Beecher's, we met it on a lovely stride. Now, there is no greater feeling for a jockey, but for an eventer, it must be double the pleasure because it's so different. Captain Mark Phillips and Columbus did the Queen proud.
Well, here is the man who's experienced some of those crazy moments. Richard Pitman, you're still here to tell the tales.
Yeah, but wasn't I handsome, athletic and hairy in those days?
And you still are.
But we can't do those sort of things now, Rich, because health and safety, insurance, everything else.
Strange, though, because the National Hunt game is nothing like about health and safety, is it? It's full of some crazy people.
Anything but. But, you know, it was great. And Harvey Smith got on the horse that fell at Beecher's, broke his spot, collarbone, gets up. I've come here to ride the track, he said.
do you remember the jockey cam from the 1980s?
Oh, it weighed 12 pounds, Rich, and batteries strapped all around my waist. I mean, it was absolutely mad. Ernie Fenwick was leading us. Maureen Haggis was the other one. It was quite incredible. But 12 pounds, the batteries weighed 20. I mean, it's just madness, isn't it?
And just remind us of who the superstars were in those days, jockey-wise.
Jockey-wise, it was the Biddlecombe, Josh Gifford era, Stan Mellor, you know, and then Frankham crept into the thing.
Yeah, and then somebody else came along.
Yeah, but he was a little younger than me, yes.
A certain Richard Dunwoody.